Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll walk you through how to use the Pblock Planner in AMD Vivado. In Vivado version 2025.1, we have introduced a new feature called the Pblock Planner. The Pblock Planner streamlines the process of creating Pblocks by providing a centralized interface where all requirements for fully defining a Pblock can be accessed and managed in one location. This enhancement is designed to make Pblock creation more intuitive and efficient within your design workflow. In previous versions of Vivado, creating Pblocks was a multi-step process. Users first had to draw the Pblock and select its resources. Then they had to add the cells to the Pblock, either from the netlist window or via the Tickle console. To modify the properties of newly created Pblock, users needed to open the Pblock properties window or use the Tickle console again to set the desired properties. This fragmented workflow made Pblock creation and management less efficient and more cumbersome. In 2025.1, all actions required to fully define a Pblock are now consolidated within the Pblock Planner. To access it, click the Pblock Planner icon at the top of the device view window. When you first open the planner, many sections will be inactive until you draw a Pblock rectangle. The Snap To section, however, will be active, and it lets you choose the grid to which the cursor will snap when you draw a new Pblock. By default, it is set to tile, so as you draw the rectangle, its edges align with the device's tiles. However, at this resolution, the snapping effect is not visible. Once the rectangle is drawn, the other sections of the Pblock Planner will become populated and active. We'll explore these sections shortly, but first, let's remove the rectangle and see what happens when we select clock region snapping. When I draw a rectangle with Snap To set to clock region, the edges of the rectangle automatically align with the boundary of the clock regions, making it easier to create Pblocks that are precisely aligned to these regions. If I don't want all the resources within the clock region included in the Pblock, I can still use the site type section to exclude specific site types. For example, in this case, I'll remove the DSP sites from the Pblock range. I can add the desired cells to the Pblock using the cells section of the Pblock Planner. If I have already selected cells in the netlist window, I can simply check the Assign Selected Cells in Netlist Window checkbox to include them in the Pblock. Alternately, I can use the Cell Selector to manually add specific cells. In the Properties section, I can further customize the Pblock's behavior. For this example, I'll uncheck the IsSoft property to ensure that all cells assigned to the Pblock will be placed within its boundaries. I'll also select Exclude Placement to prevent unassigned cells from being placed inside the Pblock. Once I have fully defined the Pblock, I simply click Create Pblock to finalize it. This action not only establishes the physical boundaries of the Pblock, but also applies the specified properties and assigns the selected cells to it, all in a single step from a single location. In 2025.1, the Pblock Planner is primarily designed to simplify the creation of new Pblocks, while editing existing Pblocks remains limited. When you select an existing Pblock and navigate to the Edit tab, you'll notice that the Range, Cell, and Properties sections are inactive. These characteristics cannot currently be modified within the Pblock Planner, though this functionality is planned for a future release. However, you can add additional rectangles to an existing Pblock if you want it to cover disjoint regions. If you wish to completely redefine a Pblock's boundaries, you can use the Redraw Pblock button to remove all existing rectangles and create a new one. For example, I'll remove the two clock region rectangles from this Pblock and instead add a site-based Pblock in a different location. You may be prompted to specify how to handle the location constraints for the cells assigned to the modified Pblock. After drawing the new rectangle, you'll see that the Pblock's property settings and the assigned cells remain unchanged. Only the physical location of the Pblock within the device has been updated. If your design requires Pblocks, I encourage you to try the new Pblock Planner. It streamlines the Pblock creation process and makes managing Pblocks much easier.
Thank you for watching.